Hello. Today I will be reading Discourse with Asalayana from Middle-length Sayings, Middle 50 Discourses. Translation offered on suttacentral.net. Thus have I heard. At one time the Lord was staying near Savatthi in the Jetha Grove in Anathapindika's monastery. Now at that time at least 500 Brahmins from a number of districts were residing at Savatthi on some business or other. Then it occurred to those Brahmins, this recluse Gotama lays down the purity of the four castes. Now, who is capable of arguing about this saying with the recluse Gotama? At that time, the Brahmin youth Asalayana was residing at Savatthi. He was young, his head shaven, 16 years of age from his birth. He was master of the three Vedas, proficient in the marks of a great man. Then it occurred to these Brahmins, this Brahmin youth Asalayana is residing at Savatthi. He is young, his head shaven, proficient in the marks of a great man. He is capable of arguing about this saying with the recluse Gotama. Then these Brahmins approached the Brahmin youth Asalayana. Having approached, they spoke thus to the Brahmin youth Asalayana. Good Asalayana, this recluse Gotama lays down the purity of the four castes. You go, good Asalayana, and argue about this saying with the recluse Gotama. When this had been said, Asalayana, the Brahmin youth, spoke thus to those Brahmins. Truly, sirs, is the recluse Gotama a speaker on Dhamma, but speakers on Dhamma are difficult to argue with. I am not able to argue about this saying with the recluse Gotama. And a second time these Brahmins spoke thus to the Brahmin youth Asalayana. Good Asalayana, this recluse Gotama lays down the purity of the four castes. You go, good Asalayana, and argue about this saying with the recluse Gotama. A wanderer's life is led by the good Asalayana. And a second time Asalayana, the Brahmin youth, spoke thus to those Brahmins. Truly, sirs, is the recluse Gotama a speaker on Dhamma, but speakers on Dhamma are difficult to argue with. I am not able to argue about this saying with the recluse Gotama. And a third time these Brahmins spoke thus to the Brahmin youth Asalayana. Good Asalayana, this recluse Gotama lays down the purity of the four castes. You go, good Asalayana, and argue about this saying with the recluse Gotama. A wanderer's life is led by the good Asalayana. Let not the good Asalayana be defeated in a defeat without resistance. When this had been said, Asalayana the Brahmin youth spoke thus to those Brahmins. Sirs, truly the recluse Gotama is a speaker on Dhamma, but speakers on Dhamma are difficult to argue with. I am not able to argue about this saying with the recluse Gotama. All the same, I will go at the bidding of the reverend ones. Then Asalayana, the Brahmin youth, together with a large concourse of Brahmins, approached the Lord. Having approached, he exchanged greetings with the Lord. Having conversed in a friendly and courteous way, he sat down at a respectful distance. As he was sitting down at a respectful distance, Asalayana, the Brahmin youth, spoke thus to the Lord. Good Gotama, Brahmins speak thus. Only Brahmins form the best caste. All other castes are low. Only Brahmins form the fair caste. All other castes are dark. Only Brahmins are pure, not non-Brahmins. Only Brahmins are own sons of Brahma, born of his mouth, born of Brahma, formed by Brahma, heirs to Brahma. What does the good Gotama say about this? But Asalayana, Brahman wives of Brahmins are known to have their seasons and to conceive and to give birth and to give suck. Yet these Brahmins, born of woman like everyone else, speak thus. Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. Although the good Gotama speaks thus, yet Brahmins still consider it thus. Only Brahmins, heirs to Brahma. What do you think about this, Asalayana? Have you heard that in Yona and Cambodia and other adjacent districts, there are only two castes, the master and the slave? And that having been a master, one becomes a slave. Having been a slave, one becomes a master. Yes, I have heard this, sir. in Yona and Cambodia. Having been a slave, one becomes a master. In reference to this, then, Asalayana, on what strength and authority do Brahmins speak thus? Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs of Brahma. Although the good Gotama speaks thus, yet Brahmins still consider it thus. Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. What do you think about this, Asalayana? If a noble made onslaught on creatures, took what had not been given, wrongly enjoyed pleasures of the senses, rather, were a liar, of slanderous speech, of harsh speech, a gossip, covetous, malevolent in mind, of wrong view, would only he, at the breaking up of the body, after dying, arise in the sorrowful way, the bad born, the downfall, nidaya hell, and not a Brahman, nor yet a merchant? And would a worker, if he made onslaught on creatures, were of wrong view, would he, at the breaking up of the body after dying, arise in the sorrowful way, nidaya hell, and not a Brahman? This is not so, good Gotama. If a noble, good Gotama, made onslaught on creatures, took what had not been given, at the breaking up of the body, after dying, he would arise in nidaya hell. And so would a Brahman, good Gotama. And so would a merchant, good Gotama. And so would a worker, good Gotama. So, good Gotama, if they made onslaught on creatures, took what had not been given, were of wrong view, all the four castes at the breaking up of the body after dying would arise in the sorrowful way, the bad born, the downfall, nidaya hell. In reference to this, then, Asalayana, on what strength and authority do Brahmins speak thus? Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs of Brahma. Although the good Gotama speaks thus, yet Brahmins still consider it thus. Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. What do you think about this, Asalayana? If a Brahmin refrained from onslaught on creatures, from taking what had not been given, from wrong enjoyment of the sense pleasures, from being a liar, from slanderous speech, from harsh speech, from being a gossip, were not covetous, were not benevolent in mind and of right view, would only he, at the breaking up the body, after dying, arise in a good born, a heaven world, and not a noble, nor a merchant, nor a worker? This is not so, good Gotama. If a noble refrained from onslaught on creatures, were benevolent in mind and of right view, at the breaking up of the body after dying, he would arise in a good born, a heaven world. And so would a Brahman, good Gotama. And so would a merchant, good Gotama. And so would a worker, good Gotama. So, good Gotama, if they refrained from onslaught on creatures, from taking what had not been given, were benevolent in mind and of right view, all the four castes, at the breaking up of the body, after dying, would arise in a good born, a heaven world. In reference to this, then, Asalayana, on what strength and authority do Brahmins speak thus? Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. Although the good Gotama speaks thus, yet Brahmins still consider it thus. Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. What do you think about this, Asalayana? Is it only a Brahman who, on this supposition, is capable of developing a mind of friendliness that is without enmity, without malevolence, and not a noble, not a merchant, not a worker? That is not so, good Gotama. On this supposition, a noble too, good Gotama, is capable of developing a mind of friendliness that is without enmity, without malevolence, and also a Brahman, good Gotama, and also a merchant, good Gotama, and also a worker, good Gotama. So, good Gotama, on this supposition, all the four castes are capable of developing a mind of friendliness that is without enmity, without malevolence. In reference to this, then, Asalayana, on what strength and authority do Brahmins speak thus? Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. Although the good Gotama speaks thus, yet Brahmins still consider it thus. Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. What do you think about this, Asalayana? Is it only a Brahman who, taking a back scratcher and bath powder and going to a river, is capable of cleaning himself of dust and mud, and not a noble, not a merchant, not a worker. That is not so, good Gotama. A noble too, good Gotama, who taking a back scratcher and bath powder and going to a river is capable of cleaning himself of dust and mud. And so is a Brahmin, and so is a merchant, and so is a worker, good Gotama. So, good Gotama, all the four castes, taking a back scratcher and bath powder and going to a river, are capable of cleansing themselves of dust and mud. In reference to this, then, Asalayana, on what strength and authority do Brahmins speak thus? Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. Although the good Gotama speaks thus, yet Brahmins still consider it thus. Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. What do you think about this, Asalayana? If a noble anointed king were to assemble 100 men of varying origins, saying to them, let the good sirs come, and let those who are of noble, priestly, and royal families, bringing an upper piece of fire stick, of teak or sal, or of a sweet-scented tree, or of sandal or lotus, light a fire and get it to give out heat. But let the good sirs come, and let those who are from a despised family, a trapper family, a bamboo plater family, a cartwright family, a scavenger family, bringing an upper piece of fire stick from a dog's trough, or a pig's trough, or from a trough for dying, or dry sticks from castor oil shrub, light a fire and get it to give out heat. What do you think about this, Asalayana? Is the fire that is lit and the heat that is got by someone, no matter whether he be from a noble, priestly, or royal family, and no matter whether he bring an upper piece of fire stick of teak or sal, or of a sweet-scented tree, or of sandal or lotus, is it a fire that has flame and hue and brightness, and, being this fire, is it able to serve the purposes of a fire? But is the fire that is lit and the heat that is got by someone, no matter whether he be from a despised family, a trapper family, a bamboo plater family, a cartwright family, a scavenger family, and no matter whether he bring an upper piece of fire stick from a dog's trough, or a pig's trough, or from a trough for dying, or dry sticks from a castor oil shrub, is it a fire that has neither flame, nor hue, nor brightness, and being this fire, is it unable to serve the purposes of a fire? That is not so, good Gotama. Whoever from a noble, priestly, or royal family, bringing an upper piece of fire stick, of teak or sal, or of a sweet-scented tree, or of sandal or lotus, lights a fire and gets it to give out heat. This fire has flame and hue and brightness, and is able to serve the purposes of a fire. And two, whoever from a despised family, a trapper family, a bamboo plater family, a cartwright family, a scavenger family, bringing an upper piece of fire stick from a dog's trough, or a pig's trough, or a trough for dying, or dry sticks from a castor oil shrub, lights a fire and gets it to give out heat. This fire too has flame and hue and brightness, and is able to serve the purposes of a fire. So, good Gotama, all these fires have flame and hue and brightness, and are able to serve the purposes of a fire. In reference to this, then, Asalayana, on what strength and authority do Brahmins speak thus? Only Brahmins form the best caste. All other castes are low. Only Brahmins form the fair caste. All other castes are dark. Only Brahmins are pure, not non-Brahmins. Only Brahmins are sons of Brahma, born of his mouth, born of Brahma, formed by Brahma, heirs to Brahma. Although the good Gotama speaks thus, yet Brahmins still consider it thus. Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. What do you think about this, Asalayana? Suppose a noble youth were to consort with a Brahmin girl, and as a result a son were born to them. Would that son of the noble youth and the Brahmin girl be like his mother and also like his father? And should he be called noble and also Brahmin? Whatever son, good Gotama, were born to a noble youth with a Brahmin girl, he would be like his mother and also like his father, and he should be called noble and also Brahmin. What do you think about this, Asalayana? Suppose a Brahmin youth were to consort with a noble girl, and as a result, at a son were born to them. Would that son, and should he be called noble and also Brahmin? Whatever son, good Gotama, were born to a Brahmin youth and a noble girl, he would be like his mother and also like his father, and he should be called noble and also Brahmin. What do you think about this, Asalayana? Suppose a mare were mated with an ass, and as a result, a foal were born of this mating. Would that foal of the mare and the ass be like the mother and also like the father? And should it be called horse and also ass? Because if it's Gotama, it is a mule. This good Gotama is a different, but elsewhere, for the others, I see no difference at all. What do you think about this, Asalayana? There might be two Brahmin youths here, uterine brothers, the one skilled in the Vedas, educated in them, the other unskilled, uneducated. To which of these would Brahmins first serve offerings for the dead, or cereals, or oblations, or meals for guests? Good Gotama, Brahmins would first serve offerings for the dead, or cereals, or oblations, or meals for guests, to that Brahmin youth, who is skilled in the Vedas, educated in them. For, good Gotama, what great fruit could there be of a gift to an unskilled, uneducated person? What do you think about this, Asalayana? There might be two Brahmin youths here, uterine brothers, the one skilled in the Vedas, educated in them, but of bad moral habit, of evil character, and the others not skilled, uneducated, but of moral habit, lovely in character. To which of these Brahmins first serve offerings for the dead, or meals for guests? Good Gotama, Brahmins would first serve offerings for the dead, or meals for guests to that Brahmin youth who is not skilled in the Vedas, uneducated in them, but who is of moral habit, lovely in character. For, good Gotama, what great fruit could there be of a gift to a person of bad moral habit, of evil character? First you, Asalayana, went on about birth. Leaving birth, you went on about mantras. Leaving mantras, you arrived at the purity of the four castes, which is just what I lay down. When this had been said, the Brahmin youth, Asalayana, sat silent, ashamed, his shoulders drooped, his face cast down, overcome with disappointment, at a loss for an answer. Then the Lord, understanding why Asalayana, the Brahmin youth, was silent, ashamed, his shoulders drooped, his face cast down, overcome with disappointment, at a loss for an answer, spoke thus to Asalayana, the Brahmin youth. Once upon a time, Asalayana, while seven Brahmin seers were living in leaf huts in a stretch of forest, a pernicious view like this arose in them. Only Brahmins form the best caste. All other castes are low, heirs to Brahma. And Asalayana, the seer Ashita Devala, heard. Indeed, seven Brahmin seers are living in leaf huts in a stretch of forest, and a pernicious view like this has arisen in them. Only Brahmins form the best caste, heirs to Brahma. Then Asalayana, the seer Ashita Devala, having trimmed his hair and beard, having clothed himself in a pair of crimson-colored cloths, having put on sandals with many linings, and taking a staff made of gold, appeared in a cell in a hall of the seven Brahmin seers. And then Asalayana, as the seer Ashita Devala, was pacing up and down in the cell in a hall of the seven Brahmin seers, he spoke thus, "Now where have these revered Brahmin seers gone? Now where have these revered Brahmin seers gone?" Then Asalayana, it occurred to the seven Brahmin seers. Who is it who, while pacing up and down like a village lad in a cell in a hall of the seven Brahmin seers, speaks thus? Now where have these revered Brahmin seers gone? Now where have these revered Brahmin seers gone? Then Asalayana, the seven Brahmin seers put a curse on the seer Ashita Devala, saying, "Become a vile cinder." But Asalayana, the more the seven Brahmin seers cursed the seer Ashita Devala, the more lovely became the seer Ashita Devala, the more good to look upon and the more charming. Then Asalayana, it occurred to the seven Brahmin seers, Vain is austerity for us, fruitless the Brahma faring. Formerly, when we put a curse on anyone saying, become a vile cinder, he became as a cinder. But the more we put a curse on this one, the more lovely he becomes, the more good to look upon, the more charming. Austerity is not vain for the revered ones, nor fruitless the Brahma faring. But revered sirs, please get rid of your misapprehension about me. We will get rid of whatever misapprehension there is. But who is the revered sir? Is the seer Ashita Devala known to the revered sirs? Yes, sir. I, sirs, am he. Then Asalayana, the seven Brahman seers, approached the seer Ashita Devala in order to honor him. Then Asalayana, the seer Ashita Devala, spake thus to those seven Brahman seers. I have heard this, good sirs. While seven Brahman seers were living in leaf huts in a stretch of forest, a pernicious view like this arose in them. Only Brahmins form the best caste. All other castes are low. Only Brahmins form the fair caste. All other castes are dark. Only Brahmins are pure, not non-Brahmins. Only Brahmins are own sons of Brahma, born of his mouth, born of Brahma, formed by Brahma, heirs to Brahma. Yes, sir. But do you, sirs, know whether their mothers consorted only with Brahmins, not with non-Brahmins? No, sir. And do you, sirs, know whether their mothers' mothers, back through seven generations, consorted only with Brahmins, not with non-Brahmins? No, sir. And do you, sirs, know whether their fathers only consorted with Brahman women, not with non-Brahman women? No, sir. And do you, sirs, know whether their fathers' fathers, back through seven generations, consorted only with Brahman women, not non-Brahman women? No, sir. But do you, sirs, know how there is conception? We do know, sir, how there is conception. There is here a coitus of the parents. It is the mother's season, and the being waiting to be born is present. It is on the conjunction of these three things that there is conception. But do you, sirs, know whether that being waiting to be born is a noble or Brahman or merchant or worker? We do not know, sir, whether that being waiting to be born is a noble or a Brahman or a merchant or a worker. This being so, do you know, sirs, who you are? This being so, sir, we do not know who we are. Asalayana, these seven so-called Brahman seers, on being questioned, cross-questioned, and pressed for an answer by the seer Ashita Devala, concerning their own claims to lineage, were not able to explain. So how can you, on being questioned, cross-questioned, and pressed for an answer by me, now explain your own claims to lineage, you who have the same teacher as they have, but not Punna, the holder of the oblation ladle? When this had been said, Asalayana, the Brahman youth, spoke thus to the Lord. It is excellent, good Gotama. It is excellent, good Gotama. May the Gotama accept me as a lay disciple going for refuge from this day forth for as long as life lasts.